our minds and think through them, take our hands and work through them, take our hearts and set them on fire. Amen. This person was Jesus. And this is why when we come together to pray and to tell our stories, we light candles, to remind us that the light came into the world and lived among us. On this night, we light many candles, because this night is like no other. On this night, we tell our favorite story as we come close to the mystery. We celebrate the mystery that is the inbreaking of God with us, the incarnation, the birth of Jesus Christ. And it begins with light. The people who walked in darkness have seen a great light. Those who lived in a land of deep darkness, on them light has shined. For a child has been born for us, a son given to us, authority rests his shoulders, and he is named Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. His authority shall grow continually, and there shall be endless peace. For the throne of David and his kingdom, he will establish it and uphold it with justice and righteousness from this time on forevermore. These words from Isaiah are a promise. They tell us something essential about the God we trust, that we will not be left alone in the shadows of our lives. God has come. God is coming. God will always come to be with us. And so it is that we travel again tonight the familiar road to Bethlehem. We know by heart that when the time came for Mary to deliver her child, he was wrapped in mats of cloth and laid in a manger, because there was no room for them in the inn. Our hearts stir with expectation as the glory of the Lord shined around the shepherds living in the fields, keeping watch over their flock by night. Our hope is found in the words of the multitude of the heavenly host, who praise God, saying, "Glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth peace to those whom he favors." It bids us into action, running alongside the shepherds in search of love made flesh, to Bethlehem and beyond. For this is not news that we keep to ourselves. What happens in Bethlehem does not stay in Bethlehem. A love this big, this wide, this deep, this unconditional must be shared, for it has power to shine light in the shadows of our lives, in the shadows of the world, bringing peace and justice. Love is made incarnate when we open our hands and hearts in this world, feeding the hungry, clothing the naked, healing the broken, finding the lost, making peace. English poet Christina Rossetti is most famous for writing the words to, shall be our token. Love be yours and love be mine. Love to God and Omen for the plea and the gift and the song. Light and love are the gifts that God gave once for all on that birth, all those years ago. And this is why we come this night to hear our story. The story of a love so profound that it was born human and lived among us. And we come to hear again our part in the story. How it is that the work of the incarnation did not stop with Mary, but is our labor also. We are Christ's hands and heart in this world. Like Mary when she offered herself up to magnify the Lord, our lives are meant to magnify the light and love of God. Tonight, we refill our stock of oil and set our hearts on fire, that we may go forth bearing this light of Christ this night, and tomorrow, and the days and weeks to come. For we are people of light. We are recipients of the light that shone in the darkness, the light of the wild star which pierced through the night sky and pointed to the manger, the light born in Bethlehem. It begins with light. Watch the light. Do you see it? The light is no longer in one place. Now it's spreading out, getting bigger.